Hello, my name is Crystal Ferraris from Commercial Food Sanitation, and I welcome you to this series of short videos about COVID-19. These videos were developed by our team of food safety specialists at CFS, and they will focus on hygiene and sanitation perspectives for the food industry. This series on COVID-19 will begin with an introduction about the virus. This knowledge will help you understand the rationale behind the preventive measures and the remediation practices put in place to prevent the spread of the virus in your workplace and at home. Some of you may have met us already, but before we start, let me introduce you to Deanne Davis, who will review the information available to date about the virus. Then, in the second video, Richard Briette will discuss preventive measures for the food industry. And finally, in the last part, Nathan Miradamati will cover remediation practices. Now, I will turn it over to Deanne to talk to us about this virus and the disease it is causing.
Coronavirus disease, or COVID-19, is an infectious respiratory disease caused by a newly discovered coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2. Coronaviruses were first discovered in the 1930s in domestic chickens. In the 1960s, they were isolated from humans with the common cold. There are four different subgroups of coronaviruses: alpha, beta, gamma, and Delta. SARS-CoV-2, like SARS and MERS, is considered within the beta subgrouping. The coronavirus associated with our common cold is in the alpha subgroup. SARS-CoV-2 is an enveloped single-strand RNA virus consisting of four structural proteins, named the envelope, membrane, and nucleocapsid. There is a more detailed diagram of the virus and the role these proteins play in the infection process later in the presentation. Coronaviruses are known to cause disease in humans, other mammals, and birds. Coronaviruses are also considered zoonotic viruses, meaning that under certain circumstances, these viruses can move from humans to animals and from animals to humans. SARS-CoV-2, SARS, and MERS are examples of coronaviruses that have moved from animals to humans. Only a small fraction of coronaviruses present in the animal community have been characterized. Scientists still have much to learn about the circumstances that drive the movement of these viruses from an animal host to a human host. Scientists do know quite a bit about viruses and how they cause disease in humans. Although viruses have a complex structure, for example, the coronavirus consists of four distinct proteins, viruses are not alive, as they are unable to reproduce. Viruses must enter a host cell and hijack the cell's systems in order to self-replicate. SARS-CoV-2 infects a cell by attaching to a specific protein found on the cell's surface in the lung and other respiratory organs. Once attached to the cell, the virus is able to enter the cell and utilize the cell's systems to replicate. With more viral particles available, the infection can then spread to other cells within the lung and the respiratory system and cause respiratory disease. Transmission of the virus occurs primarily from contact with respiratory droplets that contain the virus. These droplets are formed when someone talks, sneezes, or coughs, and can also settle on surfaces nearby an infected person. When someone nearby breathes in the respiratory droplets or touches a surface that has become contaminated with the virus, transmission can occur. This is why physical distancing and hand washing are the best defense against the virus. Some considerations on how to manage employee safety, including physical distancing and surfaces in your facility, will be discussed in the next sections of this presentation.
The situation with COVID-19 is evolving, and we are learning more about the virus on a regular basis. For the most up-to-date information, you can visit the World Health Organization website, or your country, local health agency, or your trade organization. Thank you for listening, and please do not hesitate to reach out to CFS at our website, www.commercialfoodsanitation.com, if you have any questions.